Are you confused about what Apple Pay is and how to use it? Well, not after this video. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and in today's lesson, I'm going to teach you all about Apple Pay, what it is, how to set it up, and how to use it. Before we're done, I'm going to drop my MacWhisperer Power Tip, which is going to take everything you've learned about Apple Pay up to another level. The first thing we need to learn is, what is Apple Pay? Most people are confused about Apple Pay, thinking that it has to do with an Apple credit card or something directly related to Apple, but that's not really true. Apple Pay is just a simple way to use any of your existing credit cards without actually taking them out of your wallet. It uses a technology called near-field communication, also known as NFC. And NFC is not new and is not specific to Apple. In fact, if you have a credit card with this symbol on it, that's NFC. These credit cards use something called tap to pay, which is essentially the same technology, but built into the credit card itself. NFC uses this near field communication, which means essentially about a 4 centimeter or 1.5 inch space between one device and the other device. Usually that's your iPhone or Apple Watch and the payment terminal. Apple Pay makes using NFC super simple because all of your credit cards can be stored right here in your Apple Wallet, where you can easily access them and pay for all sorts of things without actually needing your wallet. Why does that matter and why is that important? Well, it comes down to this basic truth. Credit cards are at their core insecure. That's why there's so much credit card fraud. That's why there's all these services to track your credit cards or to lock your credit cards. That's why they put that CVV code. That's the 3-digit code on the back or the 4-digit code on the front of your credit cards. It's supposed to make credit cards even more secure, but at their core, they're not secure. In fact, the most dangerous thing that you can do with a credit card is hand it to somebody, whether it's the teller at the bank or the waiter at your restaurant or the barista at Starbucks. As soon as that credit card leaves your hand, you've got no control over what the person does. And you might think, well, I trust that barista, or I trust Starbucks, or I trust the grocery store attendant. All of these things are true, but the credit card is still massively insecure. And well, NFC or tap to pay can help with that because you're not physically handing the credit card over. You're doing what's called a contactless payment, either waving your card or your phone over the receiver. There can still be insecurities inherent in the system. Back in 2014, Target learned this the hard way because their credit card processing system at all of their branches was hacked from the inside. And over the course of a couple of months in 2014, 40 million credit card numbers were stolen because as soon as that credit card was inserted into that terminal, the hackers were able to get all the information. Whenever you swipe your card or stick your card in, it transmits all sorts of invisible information between you and the payment. It can transmit your credit card number, your name, and even the products that you purchased, meaning that whatever you did at Target or the grocery store or at Starbucks is completely trackable. And if someone malicious gets in the way of that credit card transmission, you could have all your information stolen just like those 40 million cards at Target. Sure, credit cards are becoming more and more secure, and with the chips, they're a little bit safer, and with the 3-digit codes, they're a little bit safer, but they're still just an unsafe way to make payments. Which is where Apple Pay comes in. Because when you sign up your card with Apple Pay, every time you pay with that card, the card number is scrambled and none of the information is transmitted other than the price of what you purchased, not your name, not the actual items, and not your accurate credit card number, which makes it safe and easy. So the next thing we want to talk about is how to set up Apple Pay on your phone. And it's pretty simple. You come right in here into the settings section on your iPhone and you scroll down until you see Wallet and Apple Pay. Go ahead and click on that. And from here, you'll see this section that says Add Card. When you click that, it'll give you some different options. You can add previous cards that you've had on this phone in the past, but the most common thing you're going to want to do is come down here to where it says Debit or Credit Card and click on it. Here you click the Continue button and then you're greeted with this camera that is looking for the card. Position your card so that you can put the camera directly above it, and it will scan that information directly in for you. Then you simply click the next button here, put in that 3-digit code, and click next. It usually takes a moment and then asks you to agree to the terms and conditions. Let's do that right here. And then it contacts your credit card company, confirms all of the information, but before it can add it to the wallet, you have to verify that you're the owner of that card by using two-factor authentication like this. Let's send it to my phone number and click the next button. Now I type in the verification code that I received via text and click next. If everything checks out properly, that card will be verified and added to my Apple Wallet where I can easily use it anytime I want to. You can add as many different cards as you'd like. Down here, you'll have the option of choosing which card you want to use as the default card. That means when you first trigger Apple Pay, that's the card that shows up on top. But you can have multiple different cards in your wallet at any given time and choose which one you want to use when you go to make a payment. And the last thing we're going to talk about is how to actually use Apple Pay. For clarity, Apple Pay is available on your Apple computer, your iPhone, your iPad, and your Apple Watch. Using iCloud, the same credit cards can be shared with all of your devices so you don't have to enter them in again and again and again. When you're ready to make the payment, you'll usually be right in front of a credit card terminal. Some people will ask whether they accept Apple Pay, but you don't really need to ask. What you wanna do is you wanna look for this symbol right here. This is the symbol for near field communication that works for all Apple Pay transactions. So if they accept NFC, which most people do these days, they're gonna also accept your Apple Pay. Now, using Apple Pay is really simple, but a lot of people start off by looking for their wallet on their phone and clicking on it. That's fine, but that's not really where Apple Pay lives. Apple Pay lives inside of the phone, not inside of the wallet, and it can be accessed by double-clicking the right side button twice, just like this. And as soon as I do that, it pulls up my default card. I can also come down to this area here to choose a different card, including cards that are frequent buyer cards, or even for cards like this, my electric vehicle charging card, or a Starbucks card. If anyone's ever given you a Starbucks card, you can actually add it to Apple Pay so you can use it just by double-clicking that side button. So once again, getting into Apple Pay is easy. A simple double click like this will bring it right up and allow you to choose the card that you want. Well, Apple Pay is open on your phone like this. You hold it close to the receiver, wherever that is, just like this, and it will immediately process that transaction. Some people wonder exactly where to put it on the receiver, and generally, you want to hold it right above this symbol here. Whether it's on a handheld device like this, or a credit card terminal at the grocery store, or even on most ATMs. In some cases, you may need to double-click the side button to confirm your face for the transaction to go through. But when you do it, it's done so quickly and so easily, and you know that it was safe and secure because your credit card never left your wallet. So hopefully that answers a bunch of your questions about Apple Pay and what it is and how it works, how to set it up, and how to use it. In just a moment, I'm gonna drop my MacWhisperer power tip. But before I do, drop any questions or comments down below in the comments section. And while you're down there, hit that thumbs up button if you got great value from today's lesson and you wanna share it with others. And while you're at it, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, go ahead and hit that subscription button and that notify bell. There's a ton of great lessons on their way and I'd hate for you to miss them. So now, let's step into the MacWhisperer Power Tip. Now that we understand how to use Apple Pay, I'm sure you're amazed by how simple and easy it is, and you can't wait for the next time that you accidentally leave your wallet or purse at home and can still pay for the groceries without any major complications. But there's even another amazing part of Apple Pay, and it has to do with the Apple Watch. I've had an Apple Watch since the first generation, and I'm constantly asked, what's the killer feature? And there's several of them. But the biggest feature I use all the time on the Apple Watch is Apple Pay, because having Apple Pay on your phone is great, but your phone is usually in your pocket. So when you need to pay for something with your phone, you might as well pull out your wallet. You might as well reach into your purse. It's not really saving you any time. But your watch is on your wrist, and so you don't have to reach in a pocket or dig for anything to do it. Setting up Apple Pay on the watch is super simple. From the phone that is connected to your Apple Watch, go into the Watch app here. And from here, scroll down until you get to Wallet and Apple Pay. When you click on it, you can add any of the cards that are already on your phone directly over to the watch, or by clicking the Add Card button down here, you can add a card specifically to the watch. And then by scrolling down just a little further, you can choose which default card you want to have show up on the watch when you first utilize it. This makes it so easy to pay for things because you've got your watch on your wrist and it's got the right credit cards in it. You don't need to dig in your pocket for your phone or your wallet or your purse or your credit cards. It's so simple because just by double clicking the right side button on your watch, that's the button directly under the digital crown here, you can immediately access Apple Pay. And a simple double click will bring up your default credit card, or you can easily flick through them to get to other cards to pay with anything. And you can even use Apple Pay from the watch to get yourself into concerts, into movies, or even onto that flight to see your daughter in North Carolina. It's an easy and simple way to use Apple Pay so you're not scrambling for cards or tickets or any of that kind of information right from your wrist. And that's what we've got for today's lesson all about Apple Pay. Hope you learned something new and got great value. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer. It's my passion and profession to help you get more done on your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I'll see you next time.